Coming up next, it's going to be Alex Morono taking on Derek Krantz. Krantz defending the welterweight championship of the world. Let's get some comments from the super coach, Pat Miletic, on Alex Morono.
Morono, very slick guy, very tough, hung out in this fight. Araju really put it on him for quite a while. Araju tired, though. Morono showing he had great endurance, great patience, and then great striking. Watch this. Boom, bomb goes off on Araju's face. Check it out. Both guys have their left hands down while they're throwing their right hand. Think of it this way. Your punching hand is your spear. The other arm should be your shield. They didn't have their shields up. Rolling the dice there. Both of them on that shot. Morono comes out on top, though.
We are ready for our welterweight championship fight. Let's go to Colin Cantrell.
Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome to the cage representing the Woodlands MMA, Alex Morono.
No wasting time for the man they call the Great White, Alex Morono. His ninth legacy fight. He's gone 4-1 in his last five. He comes in tonight on a four-fight winning streak, including three first-round finishes. Black belt in BJJ, an extensive 10-week training camp. Last time out, Morono producing one of the knockouts of the year, violence personified against Valdir Araujo. Says he's been watching Derek Krantz since he was a teenager. He used to look up to Krantz. He knows that Krantz is super aggressive. Plans on drawing Krantz into deep water. Absolutely won't go to a decision, he says. Body kicks or elbows will finish the job in the fourth or fifth round.
Can't go to a decision here in Krantz's home area.
Let's get some comments from the super coach on Derek Krantz.
Just like in the Alex Morono highlight, you're gonna see something here. Beautiful KO with that powerful left hook of Derek Krantz. But when we look at it in slow motion, again, both guys throwing bombs here, left hooks with their right hands down. Krantz has happened to land. Krantz has a solid chin, but you do not want to get hit with a left hook with your hand down like that while you're throwing the hook. You double the power rotating into it. He ended up landing it, came out successful. Rolling the dice in MMA, buddy.
The champion, D-Rock Derek Krantz, about to make his way out.
Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome to the cage, representing Team 515, Derek Krantz.
His first ever championship defense. After he knocked out Brock Larson to win the title. D-Rock Derek Krantz in his eighth legacy fight. 7 knockouts, 10 submissions overall in his career. Has never won by decision. He's a finisher. Brown belt in BJJ. 8-week training camp for D-Rock. The champion knows that Morono is unorthodox. Says he's hard to read. Believes he will need to chase him but doesn't want to. Wants to use angles, wants to circle out, not be flat-footed, land his shots and peel off.
Yeah, it's interesting. There's going to be a lot of mind games going on in this fight. Morono knows he's got great endurance and he wants to drag this fight later on. He'll try to absorb the punishment from Krantz. Knows Krantz is going to be very, very powerful early on. Krantz knows he's got to kind of pull his foot off the gas pedal a little bit now and then and not fall into that game plan of Morono because he knows what Morono's up to.
Let's take a look at the tail of the tape for the welterweight championship main event. Experience goes the way of Krantz. He has 2 years the older, 1 inch the shorter. Reaches even in the arms. Reach is even in the legs. Our experts fight gauge. Striking even. Ground and speed even. Strength goes to D-Rock, endurance goes to Morono. On paper, a fantastic matchup. Who will prevail inside the legacy cage? D-Rock in the cage. Morono refuses to look at him. Let's go to Colin Cantrell.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Bossier City, are you ready? It's time for the big one. Ladies and gentlemen, our main event of the evening is being brought to us by Yamaha and is scheduled for 5 championship rounds in the Legacy Welterweight Division. Introducing first, on my right, fighting out of the Star Motorcycles blue corner. He stands 5'11" tall, his official weight, 169 pounds. This Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt holds a record of 11 victories against 3 defeats. Fighting out of the Woodlands, Texas, Alex, the Great White Morono! And across the cage on my left, fighting out of the Yamaha red corner. He stands 5'10" tall, weighing in at 169 and 1 quarter pounds. The submission fighter holds a record of 17 victories against 8 defeats. Fighting out of Marshall, Texas, the reigning, the defending Legacy Welterweight Champion of the World, Darryl D-Rod Krantz! Referee, get final instructions.
Bring it together, guys. All right, this is a title fight. Title fight, five-minute rounds. You've already been given your pre-fight instructions. Obey my commands at all times. Protect yourselves at all times. You can touch gloves now if you'd like. Go back to your corner, be ready to fight.
We are ready for 5 rounds of action. You know Morono wants to take you to deep water. You know that D-Rock wants to finish it quick. Michael Chiavello, Pat Miletic with you. Krantz, the favorite, at minus 280. Come back on Morono, plus 200. The welterweight championship of Derek Krantz is on the line. Krantz comes out hooking. That's how he knocked out Brock Larson.
Well, so much for taking the foot off the gas pedal. We're starting quick.
Take down from D-Rock. The champion looking to control things early. Goes to side control.
And smart to land inside control against the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. Great position. Trying to keep his head down, not give that arm back to Morono. They're going straight to mount.
No wasting time here for the champion.
He's got that wrist also.
Gets the mount on Morono, postures up to work the right hand. A furious start here from D-Rock. Morono almost gives up his back.
Krantz, good job spinning there. Now he's just going to suck his left leg backwards and out.
Tremendously strong individuals.